Welcome to the FiLMiC channel. In this tutorial, we're going to take you through DoubleTake, the free multicam video app on iOS for XS and 11 series iPhones. While you can download DoubleTake on older devices, Apple does not support multicam capture on them and they're limited to a single cam capture only. After first launching DoubleTake, you'll enter the main recording interface. In the upper left is the library button. In the top right is your shooting mode selector, which is grayed out now because we just have one camera selected. In the lower right is your record button, and in the lower left we have the all-important camera picker. Tap it once to open the camera picker. All available video feeds are displayed here, allowing you to select any combination of two lenses for your recording by tapping to define your A camera and your B camera. You can tap a selected lens to deselect it and choose another. Once two lenses are selected, you can use the mode button in the upper right to choose between three shooting modes: discrete, picture-in-picture, or split-screen. Your mode can be easily toggled from the main record screen, so we'll cover what each mode does from there in just a moment. For now, I'll leave it set to discrete. In the lower right, you can set your frame rate and choose between 24, 25, and 30 frames per second. Once your lens combination and frame rate selection is made, tap confirm to exit the camera picker. The A camera fills the entire screen in DoubleTake, and the B cam fills the pip overlay. This allows you to accurately preview both cameras at all times, even when using the rear and front cameras together. The B cam pip can be dragged around the screen and released over any of the anchor points. You can also swipe the pip off screen to hide it, and recall it by tapping the caret icon. You can even take your pip B cam full screen by tapping the expand button. When the B cam is taken full screen, you can swipe it up or down to hide it, and bring it back in by tapping the caret, as well as minimize it by tapping the minimize button in the upper right. For focus and exposure, DoubleTake uses a conjoined reticle. Tap once to set an area of interest, and tap the reticle again to lock this value, which turns it yellow. What is really cool is that this conjoined reticle is supported on both cameras. If you want to adjust your focus and exposure on the B cam, just tap to enlarge the pip, and then tap on your area of interest, and tap again to lock it. The reticle state will persist even when you minimize your B camera pip. Now let's look at DoubleTake's three shooting modes, which can be cycled through using the mode selector in the upper right. First up is discrete mode. In this mode, DoubleTake will save two separate video files. If I start a recording, I can move my pip around, hide it off screen, recall it and take it full screen. However, when I end the recording and open up the library, you can see two discrete files have been saved. It doesn't matter what you did with your B camera pip, the camera feeds are captured in their entirety, and it doesn't matter if your B camera was off screen or not. This shooting mode is ideal if you need full control over your multicam experience in post-production. If we exit the library and return to the main recording interface, let's tap the mode button to enter pip mode. Whilst the layout looks identical to the discrete mode, the key difference is here that once you start a recording, instead of capturing two files, you get a single file that represents what you see on screen. This means that if you move your pip around, hide it off screen, or even take it full screen, this is saved to the final recording. Let's take a look at the final clip. As you can see, everything I did on screen is faithfully captured, and this eliminates the need for lengthy post-production and makes for exciting new storytelling possibilities. Let's return to the main camera view and press the mode button again to enter split screen mode. Here we get a straight 50-50 split with your A cam placed on the left and your B cam placed on the right. Just like the pip mode, this saves a single file to the library and requires no editing in post and accurately reflects what you see on the screen. In split mode, each half of the screen has its own reticle, and these can even be set and locked at exactly the same time. I'll end the recording, and let's take a look at DoubleTake's library by tapping the button in the upper left. By using our own internal library, this means we can retain control over how clips are named, as well as color code your A and B camera clips for easier visual grouping. To save the clip to the iOS Photos app, tap the clip selector, add one or more clips to your selection, then tap the camera roll icon. To share a clip directly to another app, make a selection and tap the share icon, which will launch the iOS share target sheet. If you have a large number of clips in your library and you want to select them all at once, just long press on the clip selection button. And lastly, If you want to import your media to a computer, simply use iTunes file sharing to browse your DoubleTake media library. If you're using macOS Catalina, this is achieved directly from the Finder window after selecting your iPhone. On older versions of macOS and for Windows users, this is achieved through iTunes. Just select your device, navigate to the file sharing section, and choose DoubleTake. All clips can be easily imported from here. Thanks a lot for watching. If the video helped, remember to leave a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel, and let us know if you have any questions in the comments below.